about complex thing, and Ukrainians all speak Russian. So my report is how we apply human-centered design approach working on large-scale projects about urban design. So it's not about digital world, but about the world of processes, offline environment, subjects, items, and not just navigation. And well, when a small intro. Well, while I was preparing to this report, I got the mail from the organizers asking me to answer a pretty simple question: what is the challenge we will have to encounter in the nearest time, the most important, the major one, due to fast development of technology? And I think that there is nothing bad about fast progress of technology. It's just the problem that the speed of development of technology is really different from our development of empathy and ability to hear each other, to understand each other, to understand the problems of other people. And if the technology is progressing really fast, then, well, unfortunately, we are not as good in ability of talking to each other and hearing each other. And there are many cases supporting this idea. And very often we hear about some successful startups, technologies, and products, but most of those products, processes, technologies that are now being created, they are created because we can, or we have a business need for that, we have a desire for that to earn some money, and very rarely because it's really something people need. So that's why we every day we have 3 million internet shops cloned Amazon, because just the customers want to sell vacuum cleaners, or we use cargo cult to implement smart city technologies, routers, web cameras, and so on, without understanding what problems of people will be resolved. We introduce agile processes, scrum meetings, without understanding what problem of the employees of the company we are going to resolve using this technology. So I think I'm really actually sure that innovative design, design in the broad meaning of that, design of products, of processes, of the environment, of everything that you can come up with, some creation of chaos into a structured product, it's not about technology. Innovative design is about resolving the unresolved major problems of users, or something meeting the needs of the users in a drastically different way. And it's a very well-known diagram. This chart, proving my thought or illustrating it, it shows that innovative design is on the overlapping of three realms, and we must remember that when we develop a new technology, create products based on this new technology, we must remember that innovative design is at the crossing point of our business. There is always some customer, someone who initiates a product or service, or there are human values which we tend to forget about.
And we just develop the product based on our capacities and needs. And I do believe the design of successful project is aimed at satisfaction of the human needs. It includes services, products, spaces, etc. And I do believe that we cannot develop a good product without proper understanding of the people we design the product for, their context, motives, than the tasks that will be sold using this product. We cannot create the innovative product. It won't be beneficial for anybody. And fortunately, there is a special methodology called human-centered design, which we use in each and every our project, and it is specified in ISO 9421. It is an interactive methodology, so iterative, step by step, and it includes certain line of steps. First, we have to plan the design process. We then have understand the context, how and who will use the product. Then we have to specify the requirements to the product, develop the design solution only at this step, not before, and then we have to evaluate whether the design satisfies the needs of the customer. And only if the needs are satisfied, we should switch to the next iteration. So I will go step by step the whole process and illustrate how we use it in our work. After the first stage of planning, we have to identify the users of the product or service, or the improved process, in which situation people will use this product and for which task. Fortunately or unfortunately, there is no expert opinion, because experts are future users. So, and experts are people who have special knowledge. But in our case, people are ordinary people, and they are the source of information for the innovative product. And here we face the challenge how to get this knowledge, and we have to have a study. And here there are some people are scared of them, but actually the study is a questionnaire, and we have to interview people. To in order to know people, you have to talk to them. We talk to people every day. Why shouldn't we do that during designing our product? In this picture, you can see the interviewing people near the Darnitsa administration, because we are going to modernize, upgrade the park, and we made this map, and people were able to put the stickers on certain points and provide their recommendation. We also interviewed them to understand their motivation. When we are talking about navigation, we try to find out what people usually need to find in this particular point. Now here you can see we are talking to this wonderful woman. We are interviewing the current users of the navigation, the users of the current navigation system. They are trying to use it despite all its faults. So in Darnitsa we put the map, and we also put some markers and ask people to express their vision. And just after one day we get this very, very comprehensive picture. And people always try the opportunity to express this vision and their needs. And people sometimes have debates on whether they need some playing ground for children or whatever. If there is no place for stickers, they just write on the map. And we also observe the people. In this picture, you can see we got the idea that we could go down in the metro with this special uniform, and to pretend to be the metro officers, and we got a lot of insights that we couldn't get just sitting at the desk without being in the context. You could never invent the questions. So, for example, people perceive escalator as the only way to get outside, and that is the reason why they don't use the passage from one station to another. After that state, after we identify the needs, we can elaborate the product itself. What are its concept? What requirements are to the product? What are the criteria of whether the product is good or bad? And we have to specify our terms of reference. It could be just a list of requirements. For example, we have elaborated two documents. After studying public space in the city administration, we are trying to reconstruct the first floor of the administration. So we just at this stage we specify the concept. We were not waiting for some insight, and we just follow the term of reference. And then we start designing. Unfortunately, in most cases, designs start from this stage. But we are trying to find the design solution, and we are looking for the prototypes of the solution without spending a lot of efforts and time for that. For example, this carton and printed papers was the prototype of the column in Lvivska Square, and it was really very. We saved a lot of time, and we could test it. And again, this is our prototype in the metro station, and it was really helpful. This is the prototype for putting some money on your metro card. So we made it of some very cheap materials. They just printed some signs in order to pretend to simulate this box, and in order to test it. My favorite example is that everything can be prototyped. It is Times Square. Maybe many of you know that it has now it is the just a pedestrian area, and it was a long process of 9 years to transform it in a working area, and there was a very long process to test whether it is really very good to transform it into a working area. And we actually just skipped this phase of testing. We think that we will find the best solution from the very beginning. One more example in New York, how this space, the street space can be used. It is the street furniture. I think it's Italian guys who are testing public spaces, just created public spaces. This is the picture of workshop 2 weeks ago. The guys tried to simulate the new delivery mechanism to identify whether it is the process is comfortable for the user. So, and next step we have to test our project. So it is we have the only thing we have it is a hypothesis. It is our ideas, though they are evidenced by testings. We need that not to prove to ourselves or to the customer that we did the right things, but it is necessary to find the errors, some mistakes. There is no one who could design the product, the eventual product from just overnight. So testing could be done in different ways. Here we are testing new street signs, and here we just put these wallpapers in the metro stations, and we just watch how people use them. We just spent less than an hour to create it and 2 hours for testing. We also do shadowing. We ask somebody to do something, and then we follow him and ask him to think in a loud voice, just to explain us what people, how people perceive our products. For example, street sign. This guy is a Mexican guy, and the person is just go along the streets, and we just try to understand his perception of our product. And this is the comprehensive feasibility test. Testing, the person gets the full task and try to cope with it. Here you can see this the interface in the real pattern, which is installed in one of two stations. I do agree with the experts saying that you can develop interface, good interface, just occasionally, and if it is a very small one, just replace the word interface with anything else, infrastructure, product, and the statement will be true as well. And one more statement. We should invest in testing because it is the most useful and beneficial for you as a designer. Then we analyze our mistakes, we correct our mistakes, and then we implement our product. After the implementation, we can develop new versions. You can feel it as very, very good. Complex project, but our paradigm contains 3 points. I think it would be useful for you if you are not a designer, but develop something, for example, your internal company process. So the first one, you can know what people need only from the people. Then we develop the product in iterations, and in order to understand our progress, we test our solutions before implementation, and we test them with the help of people. Only people can tell us whether we are successful in finding the solution. I think the process is universal because I used to be involved in developing interfaces, and I'm also the manager with our organization, and we apply this paradigm for all and any process. Now we are updating the street Yaroslavl Val, and we also were engaged in metro navigation and street navigation, city administration, building reconstruction. All these projects are very different, and it's the human center design methodology seem to be successful, and that's why I'd like to thank you for your attention and develop and design your technology thinking about the people you are working for. Thank you.